Colleagues, today we have a bill to reaffirm our values as a state, that in Oregon, we protect all persons who call Oregon home. We have the opportunity to protect the most vulnerable amongst us and give our local public bodies the clarity that they so seek. This bill has raised many questions today, and amongst those is what rights do persons without documentation have, and who is considered to be an Oregonian? And what values will our state ultimately stand for? Let's start with rights. Are we a nation of laws? What is the rule of law? The decennial census is mandated by the Constitution, Article 1, Section 2, and is crucial to our democracy. The 435 members of Congress are proportioned according to this count, and it counts all persons, regardless of immigration status, age, or ability. In the Supreme Court reaffirmed this understanding in a unanimous decision in Evanwall v. Abbott in April 4, 2016. An undocumented person residing in a state is counted as a resident of the state for the purpose of representing all people of a state in Congress. The census is also used in that total count for state legislative districts. Undocumented people who reside in Oregon are counted and represented at the state and federal level. Their status as residents of Oregon, even without legal federal immigration status, is recognized by the Constitution and reaffirmed by the Supreme Court. Section 1 of the 14th Amendment states, "No state shall make or enforce any law which shall abridge the privileges or immunities of citizens of the United States, nor shall any state deprive any person of life, liberty, or property without due process of law, nor deny any person within its jurisdiction the equal protection of the laws." The case of undocumented persons being covered by and protected by the Constitution has been settled law for 129 years and rests on one word, personhood.